I'm going to start the second part of this video by talking about not being afraid to fix mistakes, even when you're pretty far into a piece. So I've been working on this piece for 5 days now. Just a little bit at a time, by the way. Remember, I work full time. Decided that the head is just too big for this. So even when you're this far along, don't be afraid to do some major editing of the work. I'm going to cut the Sculpey away from the armature. I'm not going to take it off entirely because I can just loop it back on again when I'm done. Peel this off. A little disturbing to look at, isn't it? All right. Now at this point, I take off all of this aluminum foil because the wire loop that I have under here is too big. So without taking off the aluminum foil, I can't fix that wire loop. There's some of it. Sometimes the foil can be a little stubborn. I'm trying not to tear it too much so that I can reuse it as I'm going along here. Alright, so you can see there's a fairly big wire loop here. What I'm going to do cut off a chunk of that. And edit it down to be smaller, because this is supposed to be a cat head. And cat's heads are not as tall as human heads, which I don't think I was thinking about when I first did this. Okay, so now I'm going to add the foil back on again, put the Sculpey back on, and sculpt the head. And I will come back later to show you how that ended up looking. Something to add about not being afraid to fix mistakes. We all make mistakes. Those who are willing to fix them are the ones who are successful. So keep that in mind. That being said, I was working on the face of my cat lady, and realized that I should probably do a little bit of a demonstration on how to make eyes, because most reptiles and mammals have eyes that are set into their heads, and most beginners seem to have a problem making eyes that look like they're in the head rather than sitting on top of the head. So the first thing you need for any critter with an eye is an eye socket, because we all have skulls, even fish. And our eyes are set back into those skulls. So start off with an eye socket. And then you're going to literally make an eye ball. So I'm going to take a chunk of Sculpey, make it into a ball, test and see if it fits. One of the real challenges here is making sure that your eyes match. So I've already created one eye on this cat. And the eyeball that I just added there is clearly too big, so I need to make it a little bit smaller. You don't want the eye to stick out of the head. If the eye is sticking out of the head, it will look more like an alien. Although if you're going for an alien, make the eye stick out of the head. So let's see about that one. I think that works. I think that matches. So then you're going to make little coils of Sculpey and flatten them to create eyelids, which on some creatures are arranged differently than on others, but we all have some way of covering our eyes. And most creatures' eyes are stuck back behind cheekbones as well. This is a little bit delicate work. And having small tools here is very important. Big tools are just not going to help you. So I'm now working those eyelids back into the face. I need to be careful because I tend to make everything look human since I have sculpted so many humans. That is what I know best. I need to make sure I remember to keep this looking like my cat. Fortunately, I have a cat who keeps on wandering into my studio, so I've been using him as a model, whether he knows it or not. Alright. So I now have an eye that is set back in the face. Doesn't quite match the other eye, so I'm going to have to spend some time fussing around and making the eyes match. That is always the biggest challenge. It's not that hard to make one convincing looking eye. It's getting the two eyes to look like they go together that's the real challenge. That's what I've got so far. You may be tempted to carve texture on the eyes. I advise against it. I would do any detail of the eyeball with paint rather than with texture, because it tends to look awkward when it's done if the eyeball has texture on it. So I will later establish the cat's iris and the color of the eyeball with paint, which should be coming fairly soon. I need to add the other ear to the cat, give her some hair, give her her cape, finish the fur texture that I've been doing on the body, which you may not be able to see because this is not the best quality video, but hopefully once I paint it, it will be emphasized and you'll be able to see it better. So that's where I'm at right now. I've started to add hair to the figure, and because I want the hair to be flying out behind the figure, I've had to add some wire. You've probably discovered by now that Sculpey is not going to hold itself up well. So what I'm going to do is, with these wires that I've added, continue to add little bits of hair at a time, and hopefully those four wires will be enough to hold the whole mass of hair up. If they're not, I'll add more. I just shove them back into the aluminum foil that's inside the head, and that's what's holding them up. So anything that you want to have sort of flying out like that, or sticking out, you'll need some sort of support inside of it. Another great approach would be to get some wire mesh. Say you wanted a cape. Wire mesh would be fantastic to hold the cape out. So if you're trying to figure out how on earth you're going to get something to stand horizontally that's made out of Sculpey, this is how. You use some wire supports. When you're adding hair to a piece, if you want the hair to look like it's actually belonging to the figure, you need to, at the forehead, work the extra clay slash Sculpey that you've added on into the forehead of the creature. Otherwise, it's going to look like a wig sitting on top of the head. So that hairline is particularly important. So hopefully you can see that here I have blended the Sculpey I've added back into the forehead of the figure. And I'm just going along the entire hairline, doing that. Sometimes you might have like a little curl that sticks up. But for the most part, you want to work that back in. You'll notice that I built up this hair all with little coils, or snakes, or whatever you want to call them, of the Sculpey. I find that when I work that way, it allows me to be more precise about where I'm placing the material, so that I get the form that I want faster and I don't have to go back and carve anything away. But now I'm going to go back and make this all look a bit more like hair. When you're sculpting hair, you can't really show every single hair. That doesn't tend to look realistic. And quite honestly, realistically, time-wise, that's not possible. So I'm just creating hair texture, and part of what makes hair look like hair is the major forms of the hair. the big chunks of where the hair is going are important. If after having created a texture you find that you have a lot of crumbs on the surface, a damp paintbrush can be used to help get rid of all of those crumbs. Not sopping wet, just damp. You don't want to get the piece soaking wet. That little bit of water seems to help get rid of the crumbs. Dry paintbrush doesn't seem to work so well. I definitely encourage you to take this extra step because those crumbs tend to look like poor craftsmanship. They're unintentional. They weren't supposed to be part of the design. Here is the sculpture completely constructed. It has been baked in the oven. Notice that now it is hard. When you go to bake your object, make sure that you read the directions on the Sculpey. I clearly need to still glue this to the base. That's why it's falling over. So now this is ready to paint. When you go to paint, the quality of paint you have purchased will make a difference. So if you buy really good quality paint, you're going to thin it down a little bit because really thick paint is going to obscure any texture that you've created on your object. Also, make sure that you've got small brushes. You're not going to be happy if you only have larger brushes. This does not qualify as a small brush. This is for larger areas. You want something as small as this brush for doing details. Particularly when you get to things like eyes, trying to get into small spaces. If you're trying to divide the color between areas and you're trying to do it with a bigger brush like this, it's just not going to work. So I'm going to start painting this figure now. This is acrylic paint. I don't think that many other paints would work for this. The paints that I have here are sort of a medium quality paint, and so they're not super thick. I do still need to be careful that I am not layering them down in a way that they will leave a texture of their own, or if I do, that it's a texture that I want. So I'm going to keep on working on this and build up the color. Once I've got the base colors down, I will go back and add details over that. This is the figure with a base coat of color applied. You might be tempted to just stop at this stage. I highly encourage you to add more detail. This looks still kind of unfinished, not carefully planned out, and perhaps not cared about as much. So from this stage, I'm going to add all of the variations in color to the surface, give the fur of the cat some more interest, add some patterns, etc. Something to make the whole thing have more detail. The more detail something has, the more it will draw a viewer in. The more you draw a viewer in, the longer you keep their interest. The longer you keep their interest, the more successful you'll be. This is the finished sculpture with all of the details added. The paint is dry, everything is done, which is very exciting, and hopefully you guys will be at this stage soon. Just so you can see, this is how much Sculpey was left from the full box of Sculpey that I purchased to create this creature, so hopefully you will be able to get the same amount out of yours, just so that you can see the finished piece is approximately 15 inches tall. So keep that in mind when choosing your scale. If you're going to build something really fat, use a lot of aluminum foil to build it up. That way you won't have to use much Sculpey. Good luck!